This is the first cup that I successfully pooped out. Hey guys, so I am here to do another period video with you. Who is excited? I'm excited. Why? Because my period's done. So my period actually ended a few days ago. It was quite an uneventful one, except for the fact that I had it while on vacation in DC over this last weekend, as you guys know if you saw that vlog. So I did still review a product, however, for you guys. I wasn't gonna skip a month just because I wasn't gonna be in town. I thought that this would be an even better example of why the cups and reusable products are so great, because I was out and about every single day for hours on end on my feet while we were on vacation, and I was in a hotel, and I was in places where I didn't necessarily want to be changing out my cup, but I did successfully and comfortably, and I was also in a car for 7.5 hours at a time traveling there and back. So yeah, this month I truly did test out a product to its fullest capacity because I used it out in public, I used it while on vacation, I used it for long periods of time in the car, and I didn't have any real big issues. This month I decided to try the Skoon cup for a few different reasons. One, because a lot of you in the earlier videos did request the Skoon cup. I just never got around to doing it. I was sent this by I Love Generation Me in that big haul video, as you guys remember. And yeah, I did period panties last month. I've done cloth pads, I've done sponges, I've done all sorts of things, and I thought I would go back to doing another cup this month. And also, selfishly, I wanted to do a cuff because I needed something that I knew would probably last me for hours on end while I was on vacation. So talking about the differences in cups, these are the three that I have been successful with. I did also do a fourth cup, as you guys remember, the AIWO cup, which is downstairs somewhere in my office, never to be used again because it was awful. It was that one that had the really long funnel at the end, which you were supposed to just be able to like push the funnel together and then your blood like, you know, came out while it was still in you. Hated that cup, you guys remember. So the difference between the Skoon cup and the other two cups that I've been using, this is the Lunette in the middle, this is the Diva cup on the outside. The Lunette has been my favorite up until now, and I say that because I think I have a contender for my favorite right here. But the difference between the Skoon and these two cups is that, as you can see, these are more similar to each other, and the fact that it's not as bell shaped as this one, which this one right here, the Skoon, is a legit like bell shape, like almost like a tulip. Can you see that? Like it curves outwards like this and then curves back in, that kind of thing. It is the softest out of all three cups that I have in my hands right now, and by softest I mean that it is a little bit more, not flexible, but it's got a lot more give to it. These are built a little bit more firm, so it's just like harder to kind of push it together and mold it, whereas this one again is a little bit more soft. I've heard great things about the Skoon, especially for people who are first time users or people who are maybe smaller in their vaginal area, you know, the capacity, which by the way, a lot of people are like, just because you've had kids doesn't mean you're not tight down there, so maybe the Diva cup 2 was, you know, blah, 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 this. The size of the cup, like the one, the two, the medium, the small, that kind of thing, has nothing to do with the opening of your vaginal canal. I want to say that because you're gonna fold it and get it up there somehow. It's the capacity which is inside your vagina, like the actual, I don't know what to call it, cave or not cave, but the actual inside is what is big or small, if that makes sense. It's not your opening. It's the inside past the opening that that determines whether what size you need here. I just want to say that because a lot of you guys I think are confused because getting it, like, just because you might be tight, like when you stick your finger up there, maybe your vagina is a little bit tight, like the opening might be tight, but the inside of your vagina is what determines the size of this. It's not the little opening, it's not the door, it's the bedroom, guys. Does that make sense? Okay, so moving along from there, I've tested all three of these. The Lunette has been my favorite. The Diva cup is like my least favorite only because, again, I could feel it. As you can see though, it was a little bit too long for me. The Lunette's a little bit shorter, and that I think is why I love the Lunette so much and why it's so comfortable. But I will say that the Skoon is now my favorite. Again, I've not heard anybody complain about the Skoon really. Maybe I'm not digging. I don't really go looking for people talking about the Skoon, to be honest, but for all the people that I've talked to about the Skoon, they've all loved it, and they're people who are either smaller down there or maybe inexperienced with cups or virgins or just younger, that kind of things. So with that being said, however, you don't have to be a virgin or young for the Skoon to work for you, because obviously that's not my case. Yeah, I don't really know where I'm going. I feel like these openings of these period videos are just, I'm getting I need to eat something. I don't know. I'm just all over the place. So basically, I reviewed the Scoon this month. I will leave all the details of where you can get it underneath this video. They come in all different colors. They're very attractive. I think they're really cute. I like the fact that they are, you know, different colors. I don't know why. I think that's fun. They are softer, like I said. They are bell-shaped. And then this little thing right here, the tail, is like a pointed tip tail, whereas the Lunette is more of a flat tip. And then, well, you would have seen it with the Diva Cup. This one's more of just like a pole that comes out. There are no measurements on the side of this, unlike with the Diva Cup where you have little ounces right here on the side, and with the Lunette you have little hash marks right here as well. This one is just a plain out cup. It doesn't have any specific measurements on there, so if you're looking for a cup where you want to see like, I bled a half an ounce this month, this is not the cup for you. But if you don't care to know how much you've actually bled other than just looking at your cup, then this cup will be fine for you. Anyways, let me go on with the clips of me reviewing this. Again, as always, I do show the blood in the cup, the blood on my fingers when I take the cup out. I show my face when I'm putting the cup up there and taking it out, me on the toilet, all of those amazing things I show on camera. So if you are not comfortable seeing those things, skip to the end of this video where I talk about how I felt about it. I'll leave that link underneath here. Again, skip. I warned you if you don't want to see any blood. But if you do want to see all the bloody details, keep watching.
Alright guys, so it is day 2 of my period. I started later at the end of yesterday. Just got out of the shower. We're in a hotel room in DC, traveling, and I'm gonna stick this up me. It's about 8:30, almost 9 o'clock. So I'm gonna put the Scoon in and then I will update you guys and tell you what I think about it. Push down and up. So right off the bat, it went in pretty easily. And I can't feel it at all. It's a lot softer than the Diva Cup. A lot softer than the Diva Cup. And in regards to the Luna Cup, it's not like tons softer, but it is considerably softer as well. But it feels really good, so I'm gonna test it out today. Okay guys, so it is about 3:20. I'm gonna check in to see what is going on. As we've been kind of walking around and stuff, and I've gone to the bathroom a few times out in public, I noticed that I do have some spotting. It's not heavy though, but I don't know how heavy I'm actually bleeding right now. I won't know until I take the cup out completely. Maybe I'll take it out, maybe I'll dump it right now actually and show you guys. So, okay, I'm gonna check in real quick. But yeah, I have been spotting, and when I've wiped, there's been blood on my toilet paper, but I'm not heavily flowing at all, and I can't feel the cup whatsoever. So I don't know, maybe it's just the blood that's kind of already in the, you know, on the outside kind of coming out. I don't know. I'm pretty positive I have it incorrectly and that it's suctioned incorrectly. So we'll see. I'm gonna get it out and I'll show you guys. So I'm actually pleasantly surprised. That is all the blood that's been collecting since this morning at what, like 9? I think that's when I did my first update. There is quite a bit of blood in there. So it is working. I'm pretty excited about that. Again, I just have some spotting in my pad. I'll show you just a second. So I just put the Scoon back in and rinsed it out, of course, and all of that. This is what my pad looks like that I've been wearing all day. Yes, I'm wearing a disposable pad, only because I did bring all of my reusable panties and some pads to wear overnight and stuff. But what I'm trying to carry as little as possible when it comes to in my purse, because we are on our feet walking miles and miles around DC. So what I thought was I would wear a disposable pad on top of a reusable panty, just in case, say the Scoon didn't hold in my blood, or say I started bleeding over or something like that. It would give me one extra form of protection, if that makes sense. So I figured, say I'm heavily bleeding outside of the Scoon, and the pad would absorb a lot of that blood, and then instead of having to go all the way back to the hotel or have to carry a backup disposable or reusable pad, I could just take the disposable, throw it away, and then rely on my period panties, which I'm wearing as well. So basically, I thought that this would be a good way of carrying a little bit of things, but also still testing out the Scoon. Obviously, normal people wouldn't try a new menstrual product willy-nilly while they're out, you know, traveling, But I'm not a normal person. I'm reviewing products for you guys, and I did not want to skip this month in doing a product just because I was traveling. So now that I know that the Schoon holds up really, really well and that I am only spotting a little bit, if any, I'm just gonna rely on my period panties that I'm wearing right now. But as you can see, this little spotting, it's like really dark blood. And it's hardly like any dark blood. I think what it was probably just the old blood that was just, you know, out in my wall or my lining of my vagina that was outside of the Schoon. I think that's what was just coming out throughout the day because I've been on my feet literally all day walking. I think the Schoon is working really well. It's super comfortable. It's more comfortable than my Lunette even. We're gonna go out to eat and do some shopping in Georgetown, which is like a 1.5 mile walk from our hotel. And then of course we'll be on our feet walking around and then we'll walk back to the hotel. So I will get some more good, you know, upright standing gravity, pushing my blood down testing of this Schoon. But as you can see, it worked really, really well. So I'm quite excited about that. And I'm also excited that it's really comfortable. Like, I can't even feel it. Sometimes with a Lunette, I can feel it. Every once in a while, I can't feel this one at all. It's really comfortable. It's a little bit harder to pop open because it is on the softer side, but not impossible. And it might be worth fiddling with just because it feels so comfortable when it's in. So I will check in later tonight. It is midnight. We've been out and about on our feet. We walked 13 miles today almost. I'm exhausted, my feet hurt. Not that you guys care, this is a period video. This is not my day in the life vlog. Leaking wise, I actually didn't leak at all. Like when I went to the bathroom, which was numerous times because I've been drinking a bunch today, like fluids wise. I didn't have anything on my toilet paper. I didn't have anything on my underwear. That makes me believe that the leaking earlier wasn't actually leaking. I think it was, again, just that blood that's just outside, well, outside, but that's inside the vaginal wall, that's outside of the cup. Like, I think that's all that was. So I'm gonna pull the cup out right now and check to see how much blood's in there. I'm gonna wash it. I actually brought my Lunette wash so I could wash in between uses. This stuff, I love it. It's not like brand specific to what cup. This is just what I had, but it smells really good. I like it. Anyway, so I'm gonna pull the cup out. I'll show you guys it, and then I'll put it back in and sleep with it. But I have to say that this is the first time I've actually traveled long distance on my period. And considering all the stuff we've been doing, like we've been walking a lot. We've, you know, not necessarily had access to bathrooms like when I need, like at the drop of the dime. Like, I was really comfortable all day long and all yesterday on my period for once, and it's been really cool. So this is my first time using reusable products out, like on vacation or not vacation. Well, yeah, vacation. And I gotta say, it's made my life a lot easier, and I'm really happy, and I'm really excited about tomorrow and the drive home because I know that I'll be able to take, you know, be in the car for 7 hours at a time without having to worry about having an accident with my period. So anyways, I'm gonna pull the cup out and I'll show you guys what's there. All right guys, so there's the blood that's in there. There's not a ton of blood. It is pretty clotty, mixture of dark and bright red. The outside of the cup is pretty clean minus like the bottom ridge part, but that again is just from what was inside my vaginal wall. Like, I mean, it's my vagina. Anyways, it worked, so I don't have any spotting whatsoever in my underwear. I am wearing the Anagen ones today, and I'm pretty happy. So I'm gonna dump this in the toilet, rinse it out, and wash it with the Lunette wash, and go to bed. Look at my hair. So it is day 3 of my period, second night on my period, however. 8:30 in the morning, I'm gonna pull out my cup and update you guys. I look like a hot, hot mess. Oh my gosh. I was so tired last night. So tired. So a little bit of blood, lots of clotting around the inside. Very effective, no leaking in my underwear, nor did I have any like spotting in my toilet paper. So once again, the cup works perfectly fine. So it's 2:37. I actually just went to the bathroom. We are headed home. Like I said, it's about a 7.5 hour drive. And the cup is comfortable. I don't even feel it when it is in. But I will say that this is the first time, I had to go number 2. This is the first time where I've ever pushed a cup out while pooping. And I don't know if it's the angle I was sitting on the toilet or what, but I've never pushed one out before. Like, I could feel it coming out, and if I wouldn't have pulled it out when John's looking at me like, what?
It didn't fall in, did it?
No, it didn't fall in.
Oh.
But, like, I felt like I knew that if I continued pushing, and it would fall out. So I grabbed it, and it was, like, literally protruding, like, this much. Like, it was about to fall out. So, which is not a bad thing. I mean, I knew that that was something that could happen, because they say when you can't, if you can't get your cup to out, like if it's too far up there, you're supposed to squat down and bear down like you're pooping or giving birth. So it makes sense that it would fall out, but it's just interesting that this cup actually did that. I've been able to poop with all of the other cups in perfectly fine. But again, I don't know if it's because I was maybe pushing harder than normal, or where the toilet was, and like maybe I was sitting at a different angle. I don't know. But I would just say that that is something to think about. So next time I go to the bathroom, I'm going to remember to take the cup out prior to pooping if I have to poop. So I will say there was some blood clotting inside the cup. There's a little bit of blood. I forgot I didn't have my camera on because I didn't think that I would check my cup at that point. But it wasn't anywhere near full, and it was working. I don't have any spotting in my underwear. There's no spotting on my toilet paper, nothing like that. And again, it's completely comfortable. I am completely comfortable. I do not even feel it. Like, if I wasn't reviewing this cup, I wouldn't even, like, making these updates, I wouldn't even be thinking about my period right now. But again, it did come out, and because it is a little bit harder to open, to get up in there, it just took me a little bit longer to go to the bathroom today. So yeah, that's the update for now. It's 2:40. I had that in since like 8:30 this morning, and yeah, I'll check in again tonight, and then I think that might be my last check-in.
So I love this cup. Those are my thoughts on it. This has now replaced the Lunette in my life, just because it is so stinking comfortable. And because it's so comfortable, it makes up for the fact that it's harder to put in. And if you watch those clips, you know what I'm talking about. But if you didn't, the reason why I say that it's harder to put in is that because it is so soft, it doesn't want to kind of open itself on its own without a little bit of help for me. So when I put my cup in, I do the punch down fold, which is just like punching down one side, and it kind of looks like that. So when I put it in, I usually put it in like this, but then my cervix gets in the way. So what ends up happening is it opens like this, and then I have to grab into the base and kind of turn it and pull it down a little bit, push it back up for it to fully open. So with the Lunette and with the Diva Cup, because they are firmer cups, they tend to want to help me more than this. They tend to want to pop open because they are firmer. You know, it's just kind of the reaction that happens. But then with the Lusagoon, again, it's softer, so it just needs a little bit more help opening up completely. What I need to do is I need to start putting in my cup in a different direction. Like, I need to start putting my cup in this way instead of this way, because my cervix does kind of hang out right up here, and it gets caught. It just catches where I need my cervix to be kind of sitting on top of it to bleed into it, if that makes sense. I'll say, even though it is more difficult to put in, because it's softer, because of maybe even the shape, I don't know what, it is more comfortable than any other cup I've ever used. Lengthwise, it's even a teeny tiny bit shorter than the Lunette, like a teeny teeny tiny bit shorter. Lengthwise, opening wise, they're about the same exact width and all of that. So I do think just because it is that teeny bit shorter, it just makes it all the more comfortable. And again, it might be the size, and it also might be because it is softer that I like it so much. So I did not feel this cup. This is the first cup that I've put in that from the first time I put it in, I did not even feel like it was in. I did not feel it at all. I did not feel it throughout the day, nothing. But with that being said, this is the first cup that I successfully pooped out. And by pooped out, and if you didn't see that clip, I mean, I went to the bathroom at the gas station and I had to poop. I'm a human being. I poop. All people poop. Isn't there a book like that? Like, all things poop, that kind of thing? Anyways, I had to poop. So I was pushing, doing my thing, getting it out, and then suddenly I could definitely feel like this thing was about to just fall out in the toilet. It had probably gotten out like this far out of my vagina, and when I pushed, I was like, oh crap, I need to grab that or it's going in the toilet, and then I won't be able to use it anymore for this trip, because obviously it's unsanitary, I didn't have anywhere to boil it. Thankfully, I pulled it out just in time, and it was full of blood, but that's the first time I've ever been able to push one of these out while I poop. Usually I can keep them in, and I have to kind of maybe nudge them up a little bit more and readjust them after, but for the most part, I've never had to take a cup out while I've pooped. This one I had to, however. I think it could be just because it was so soft compared to the Lunette and the Diva Cup, so maybe when I was, you know, bearing down, I think because it was so soft, it just like kept sliding down. It wasn't holding itself open. So I will say that that's kind of a bummer because I really don't want to have to take my cup out, especially when I'm doing something as unsanitary as pooping. I don't really want to have to take that out in public without being able to boil it again. But it wasn't so bad that I wouldn't use it because it was so comfortable. Like, it was really comfortable. And honestly, I try not to make a habit out of pooping out in public. I really like to keep that stuff at home. but because I was on a trip and I only had the gas station, I had to go there. So with that being said, I did actually have to take this out and dump it in a public restroom. This is the first time I've ever had to do that with a cup. And I will say that it wasn't bad. I just pulled it out. I dumped it in the toilet. I finished doing my business. I wiped. I got up, rinsed this out with cold water. Thank you, you guys. I've heard you. You rinse first with cold, then you can do hot. But I did all those things. And then what I did was I washed my hands really, really well. And then I put this thing back up my vagina. So I did actually have those Travel Lunette cleansing pads as well. And then I also brought my Lunette cleansing wash to use in between uses with this, which I love that stuff. It works really well. But again, I was perfectly fine and comfortable emptying this and putting it back in a public restroom for everyone who's wondering. I really, really like this cup. Again, there are some downsides because it is so soft. It did come out while I pooped. It is a little bit more difficult to open. You do have to fidget around with it, especially if you have a low-lying cervix like mine that gets in the way. But in the end, it is the most comfortable cup I have ever, 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 ever used. I did not feel it at all. I was on my feet for hours on end while I was in DC. I was walking around a lot. It was probably one of my more painful periods too, because I had been off my Endovan for like 3 months because they were backordered, as you guys know. And I still was able to use it perfectly fine. It caught all the blood. The first time I inserted it, if you saw in those clips, it did leak a little bit. I don't know if it was leaking or if it was just like the blood from my vaginal wall just coming down, if that makes sense, because I was bleeding into a pad prior to putting the cup in. Who knows, but I didn't have any real big issues. I wear my period panties all the time when I'm on my period, whether I have a cup in or not. So again, that's not really an issue for me, but I wasn't leaking I wasn't leaking throughout the day though, in regards to like new blood piling up. It was just like old blood on my toilet paper or on my underwear. I will say that this was a very successful review of the Skoon. As you saw, I didn't really have a lot of days where I updated on it because my period kind of tapered off to the point of being really light, and I kind of like to give my vagina a break when that happens. Like, when I'm on my ending days, I just stick to period panties or reusable pads because I don't really like putting anything in my vagina if I don't have to. Period product wise. I just, you know, when I can take a break from putting foreign objects up there, I will. Well, I kind of stuck to my period panties and my reusable pads after that. So that's why there's not a whole lot of clips of the review, but it worked. I showed you that it worked, and I feel like it worked, and it's my favorite. That is that. I'm gonna try to keep this short because it's just another cup review. It was successful for me. I would highly suggest this cup for anybody who is really uncomfortable with the firmer cups. I think you'll really, really like this one. But again, beware, because it is softer, it will fall down if you are pooping, I think. I don't know. If you have a Skoon and you've taken like a dump and it's fallen out, let me know. Or if you feel like it's shifted more when you've done that, let me know. But in regards to everything else, squatting, walking, jumping, running, laying down, sitting down, all that stuff, it stayed in place perfectly fine for me. So I'm gonna let you go because my battery light is flashing, saying, shut up, Kelly, let these people go. If you like period products like this, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. Comment below on the next period product that you would like to see so I can do some investigating and try to get that for you for next month. And if you're on your period right now, my heart goes out to you, and I will talk to you all in my next video. Bye.